Hey guys, it's Katie here. I'm filming Alex's 10-month update in his room. I know last week or the week before I posted Alex's nursery update, and so my goal is to film all of his updates in this room from here on rather than in my living room. Just more to look at in there. So I'm hoping Buzz Lightyear, and I'm covering up Woody, but Woody will be my new background. Alex is 10 months old. Holy crap! I don't have stats as far as height and weight this month or head circumference. We didn't go to the doctor, and frankly, I just haven't had time to measure him. But they just left, and I'm getting ready to leave for work here in the next few minutes, so this is going to be a real quick update. He's still in size 3 diapers. We've transitioned solely to 12 months clothes. He still fits into 9 months, but there's some that fit and some that don't. And so I just said, forget it, and we transitioned completely to 12 months. Let's see. Eating, he's not really changed much in eating. Here in a few days, we're going to increase his whole milk in his bottles from 2 ounces to 4 ounces. It's been, as of the 15th, it will have been a month since we made the switch. So he's done very well with the 2 ounces. So we're going to try and increase him to the 4. If we notice a difference, then we'll back down to 3. And so on. But hopefully by his birthday, as long as everything goes okay, he'll be completely whole milk. Sleeping. He's still pretty much the same. Thank God. Chris, hopefully shortly, there's been some hiccups in the process. We'll be getting back to his second shift position. So Alex will be spending every night at home, which will be very beneficial to him. He's doing pretty well as far as me being on nights and letting me sleep. The way we've kind of got it worked out when Chris does work second shift is I'll come home, I'll go right to bed, or I'll try to be in bed by 9 because I don't get home till about 8:15, 8:30. Try and be in bed by 9, and then I get up at 1 or 2. It's a couple hours of sleep, but since I only work 3 nights a week, I can make up for it on other days. And hopefully I never have to do this 3 days in a row stuff that I'm doing this week again. So that's sleeping milestones. He's got 9 teeth. The 8th and 9th tooth popped through the other day. I think the one I consider 9 has been through for a while, but I never noticed it. He got his first molar, if it is a molar, on this side that we noticed. But the other day I had him laughing and I saw the same tooth on this side pop through. So it looks like it's completely broken through the skin, at least the bottom of it is, but I haven't noticed it before, so I don't know how long it's been through. And then his bottom 2 teeth, like if you're looking at him, it's the tooth on his left. So he'll have 3 teeth on the bottom and a total of 6 teeth on top. He is cruising along furniture. He gets up and walks with his walker without prompting. I think I said this before, but sorry. If he hears clapping on the TV or sees clapping, he'll clap and go, "Ray!" I said in the nursery update, he's able to stand up in his crib. He is chewing on the side rails, so we covered them. And he is able to get almost half of his body up over the side rail. So I kind of think we're going to be transitioning beds here soon, just because I would rather him fall from a toddler bed than his crib. It's a less of a way to fall. Or we might do like a Montessori bed where we put his mattress on the floor. That's still debatable. Let's see. Likes and dislikes really haven't changed. He is getting more of a temper, and it is my temper mixed with his dad's but mainly mine, so we're in for a world of hurt as he gets older. Let's see. And another, like, I don't know if it'll focus. But see this book? This is what every corner of every book he owns looks like. It's kind of driving me nuts. because I want him to play with his books and have a general like for them, if that makes sense. But he's kind of ruining them all, so we've been, if he comes in here to play with his books, we just come in with him and kind of deter him if he goes to chew on them, because I don't want him eating all that cardboard. Yeah. As far as other stuff, I really don't know what to update on, guys. It's Mother's Day this weekend. It's my first Mother's Day since I was pregnant. And I've always considered myself a mom because we had dogs and I've been an aunt and so on. But it's different being a mom on Mother's Day. So, yeah. I got a few more things for Alex's birthday. Really nothing special. Well, nothing of great importance. I got some balloons and some streamers and some napkins. I got another coffee tin from my grandma. Yeah, I don't know what else there is to update on, guys. So, short and sweet, I have to go to work. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!